Hi, I'm Lawrence.
Thomas.
Leia.
Dennis.
And Paul.
And today we'll be explaining you how to do your hair for hockey.
Hockey hair.
Hockey hair.
Hockey hair. Bad hair day.
Hockey hair.
All right. So the most important thing actually is why do you need to do your hair for hockey?
Because most of the time, a lot of girls are standing side of the line, and you have to look good, and also to impress your opponent. Because if you look like Paul, the opponent is going to be like, this guy is not able to play. So it's quite important to impress your opponent by looking amazing. That's quite important.
That's quite important.
True.
Of course not. The most important thing is that you can see properly during the match or training. If you can't see the ball in any way, you can't get the ball in your face or you don't receive the ball in anything. That's the important thing, right? To see everything.
And that's why you're still single.
Shut up. We are all going to show you a hairstyle, how to do it, and we're going ladies first, of course.
Okay, so. Hi, I'm Leia. This is my hair tutorial. If you like this video, please go to my channel. And I also do makeup and all sort of things. So,
Because
my hair is very wild and big and gorgeous. So, no, my hair is very easy. I just need one hairband. I just put it on and up. Then I look more dangerous, don't you think? Because I have to impress my opponent. Yeah. Dude, keep it just very tight so you also look a bit
Chinese.
Angry and Chinese, the whole time.
You call it fish face. Physical.
Fish face.
Fish face.
Fish face.
And then turn your hair around in a bun and make it real tight so you look aggressive. So you're on edge all the time. Just spit it. Make every little bun. That's how I always play.
This is how you always play?
Yeah.
All right. Okay, Dennis.
For goalies, it's actually quite easy because, like you wear a cap, you also always wear a helmet, of course. So the only important thing for males is just throw your hair backwards, like you felt. Throw your hair backwards and then put on the helmet, and it's done.
And for ladies?
For ladies, I have no idea. I'm not a lady.
You can't have a bun like
that. No, they have a bun over here, but you have to wear it a bit lower because the helmet is up to here. And some wear it high and then it comes out of their helmet.
So like this?
Yeah, a bit weird.
Bit where? Bit lower.
Yeah.
All right.
Wear it low so the helmets can fit on.
Okay. I am from the old school, actually. What's it called actually? It's like it's like some teeth.
No, don't make it
teeth.
Cool.
And you have to click it in.
It belongs to his mother.
So it stays in. But what actually is the great thing about it is that if you use a shoelace or some ropes or anything, it always points out some kind of little bit of hair underneath it. It doesn't stay in play. So with this thing, actually, it's very easy. Put it on your neck. Don't laugh at me.
Like
it's really serious. And so you just pull it a bit over it, and then you get underneath the hair. Get under it. Yeah, and so now you see that everything stays in touch.
And
he
looks aggressive. No,
it's
aggressive.
It's okay. It's okay.
He looks like a lunatic indeed. I
would
be scared of him.
It's okay. Yeah, so this is how I always play in my match. And if you have long hair like me, like guys, and you can't get a bun, so this is the best way.
I use this.
I use a rope.
It's not a rope. It's not a rubber lady band. It's a man hat hair band.
You also have the pin, huh?
I also have the pin.
Yeah.
Three steps. Step one. Step two.
See the little.
Step three.
So and now do your hair. Do the black pin. Do forward, back and forth. See? Now it's getting under it. You see?
But my hair is nowhere near my eyes.
Yeah. So that's only if you have long hair like me, then you have.
Yeah.
To
if you have short hair like me, then
doesn't
it's.
Really matter. That's work. Okay. Okay. Yeah. And now we get to the moy boy, the pretty boy,
expert,
the expert.
So first I want to give a shout out to Leticia from South Africa because she taught me how to do my hair and I changed my life. So I think the most important thing is that we don't use wax because wax is just for, it's not working. So we actually have to use gel.
That's wax.
This is not wax, this is gel.
This is gel.
This is gel because it's like wet and soft. That's you just put a little bit on your finger.
Shout out to.
You do a little bit on your finger, you put it in your hand and you start making sure that your whole hands are covered with gel.
With gel.
And then the only thing you have to do is make sure that this part of the hair is behind this part of the hair. And the other side, the other hand, I'm gonna go like this. You have to make sure, of course, that this part over here in the middle is nicely divided over the two ears. Maybe a little bit back.
Show it a little bit closer.
Yeah. Like this, you know? So, nice. Like there. And you know what's the cool thing now? Because you're starting to get, you're starting sweating to your game. The cool thing is, it's gonna be a little bit like this. It's not totally in your eyes, but it looks sexy. And that's important for the impressing part of your opponent. So it's still nice, it looks amazing, and I feel sexy, so I'm gonna play an awesome game. And that's, that's the way you do your hair before your game. Yeah? Some more hits, important.
That's what Thomas Tichman always says, right? Sexy hockey.
Sexy hockey.
That's what
and then you need a tent to
your opponent.
Yeah, to your
opponent. So those are actually five different ways to do your hair for your hockey match or training, which is important because you need to look sexy.
Fierce,
and you need to see the ball and everything. So.
Fierce and feminine.
But first sexy.
But first sexy, that's because you have to play sexy hockey. Thank you, Thomas. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you do so, then like it and follow us on.
I hope you like it. Follow us on Facebook.
Oh no, on Facebook? Instagram?
And YouTube.
And Snapchat, of course.
Snapchat.
And thank you for watching!